Welcome to our Marella Discovery Red Sea Cruise Vlogs. I woke up bright and early and left Paulie Morgan snoring in bed. Straight out onto the balcony, I was able to enjoy a moody sunrise with a cup of coffee. My first bit of reading was the cruise news. This is delivered to your room every evening. It contains all the information of the activities around the ships and the opening times of the bars and restaurants. It also contains some fascinating facts too. I'm a bit of a fact nerd, so for all those other fact nerds out there, here's some more information about the Marella Discovery. Launched in 1995, it started its life as Royal Caribbean's Splendour of the Seas. It was then purchased by TUI in 2016 and has been sailing as the Discovery ever since. The Discovery can carry 1,830 passengers and up to 750 crew. There are 915 cabins on board, with 357 of them being balconies. There is also a selection of suites, including the junior suite that we're staying in. After a couple of hours, I decided to get the grizzly bear out of hibernation. I can always tempt him with the promise of food. Morning, so we're off to breakfast again now. It's about 9 o'clock and then we're off to the Broadway Theatre to learn all about Petra because we're heading towards the Suez Canal. We should hit that about 10 o'clock tonight, I think.
10 o'clock, yeah.
Captain Hughes said. So, so we're off to breakfast. We're going to pop up to the island restaurant and then to the lecture. Told you food excites Paul. Look how fast he's walking.
You'll find the island's buffet restaurant on deck 9. It's open for breakfast from 6 a.m. to 11 a.m. There's loads of choice for breakfast in here, from your full English to the healthy options, tea and coffee, juices, you name it, they pretty much got it. And you always get service with a smile.
And I'm having a build your own bacon, sausage and mushroom sandwich.
Right, on to round 2. Have the option because there's a bit of fruit in it, and the syrup is made from a tree apparently, which is maple syrup.
After breakfast, we headed to the Broadway Lounge to learn all about Petra.
This was a really useful talk from one of the destination team, telling us what to expect, what to wear, and what to look out for on our trip to Petra. We booked our excursion to the Rose Red City prior to boarding, and you can find out all about that in a future episode.
Our next stop was to Deck 10 to join Gavin and the entertainment team for Walk a Mile.
This was really popular with a lot of the passengers. 4 laps of the running track on deck 10 gives you your mile.
That's windy.
So, I thought we were having a phone test, so that's why there's a big coolness. Yes, it is quite windy, but it's still beautiful. It's walk a mile time.
So we're just on the walk a mile.
Because we've done some exercise before, we deserve.
Beer and a raspberry colada, my favourite. After enjoying our drinks, we headed back to our cabin. There we are. Honey, I'm home. Oh, we love our cabin. We're going to just chill out here now on this perfect tier. One tip is when we sailed from Naples, heading towards Suez Canal, we did our research to show that if you like sunshine on your balcony, book a starboard cabin, not a port, because obviously all the ports are in shade and we've got lovely sunshine. So remember that if you're booking this particular itinerary.
Yeah. Very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Captain here with a noon update. Well, we're still plugging away on our southeasterly course towards the Egyptian coast, and now less than 200 nautical miles to go before we drop the hook off Port Said around about 10 o'clock this evening. So once we've anchored later on tonight, firstly we should get a visit from the authorities, and after that we wait to get issued a time slot for the southbound convoy, which should be in the early hours, around about 3 o'clock in the morning or so, at which time we'll heave up the anchor and start to make our way into the canal. It's 120 miles through the canal, so don't worry about missing the beginning as we enter in the dark, because we'll be transiting for nearly the whole day tomorrow.
After the informative announcement from Captain Hugh, we decided to chill out on our balcony as we headed towards the Egyptian coast.
After a lovely couple of hours chilling on our balcony, we headed to the pool deck to find some shade.
Whilst on the pool deck, we were spotted by fellow travel bloggers Mark and Marie Travels. We've interacted many times online with Mark and Marie, but this is the first time we met in person.
We hit it off straight away and arranged to meet in the live room for the quiz. Even with their help, we didn't do very well.
After the quiz, we realised that we had quite a lot in common, so we thought we'd have a couple of drinks and a bit of a chat. However, this turned into a 6-hour drink-a-thon, and this is the result. Quite a camera-shy couple, and sadly, this is all we can reveal of their identities.
Mark and Marie are really honest and informative travel bloggers. If you want to find out more, do check out the link in the description below.
After completely losing track of time drinking with Mark and Marie, we only just managed to make it to the late show in the theatre. Tonight's show was Marella's take on West Side Story, Songs from the West Side, starring assistant cruise director Louis as Officer Krupke. Another fantastic show from the Marella Show team, we thoroughly enjoyed it. We stayed in our seats because straight after was the comedy magician Andre, who put on an extra show.
Realising we hadn't eaten for hours, we headed up to the Glasshouse for the late buffet.
A light snack of lamb vindaloo, chips and naan bread went down very well. Back to the cabin, and it's a quick study of the cruise news to see what tomorrow's got in store for us. And then I get the great news from Carole that we're getting up at 5:30 in the morning to watch the sun rise over the Suez Canal. I really can't wait.
Join us in our next episode to see if we got up for our first Arabian sunrise. Thanks for watching. Now don't forget to subscribe and watch these videos next.